Hi, welcome to Expert Academy. This is the lecture in physics. In this video, we will discuss about the what is the magnetic field around the straight current carrying wire and the circular current carrying wire. I should experiment Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule. See the first topic in this video, magnetic field around a straight current carrying conductor and circuit. Look at here, this is the straight current carrying wire. This is the straight current carrying wire. It is a conductor. Here, the current is passing through downward to upward. And here current is passing to from upward to downward. At this downward to upward motion of the current, the field lines, so this is the field lines. The field lines are moving in anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. Coming to downward direction of the current, in this conductor the field lines are moving in clockwise direction. The current which is moving upward, at here magnetic field lines are moving anti-clockwise direction. The current is moving downward, the field lines are moving clockwise direction. So this is the magnetic field around the straight current carrying wire. Next, magnetic field around circular wire or circular loop. See here, when a circular loop of the area capital A carries a current I, okay, see this circular loop. Here, in this loop, we have two terminals, plus minus. The loop creates a magnetic field around it. When it is creates the magnetic field, the current is passing through this conductor. At that time, the magnetic field is created around this loop. The strength of the magnetic field created depends on the current through the conductor. The strength of the magnetic field is depends upon the current the conductor. At the center of the loop, the magnetic field lines are perpendicular to the plane of loop, which provides the magnetic moment, M is equal to I into A. This is the magnetic moment. Hence, it behaves like magnet. So like this, this loop behaves like a bar magnet. Okay. So not only bar magnet, so what is the field lines created in the magnet? This loop creates the magnetic fields. Both are the similar. So what is the inner meaning here? The field lines created by the loop, which is equal to field lines created by the magnet. Okay. The comparison between the magnetic field lines around a current carrying loop and a bar magnet shows the two patterns are similar. See here. This is the loop. Here, north and south pole indication. This is the field lines in circular form. This indicates like this. This field lines indicates this one. So that's why the loop creates the field lines which are similar to field lines created by magnet. If the current in the loop is in the anti-clockwise direction, a north pole is formed. When the current is anti-clock, that means the pole is north pole. Next, if the current is clockwise, that is south pole. Okay. Whenever there is a south pole, the current direction is clockwise. Whenever there is a north pole, the current direction is anti-clock. Coming to Oersted experiment. Look at here, there is a battery, this is the switch, This is the retard stand. This retard stand kept some insulating plate. Here there is a magnets. Sorry, it is a iron powder. So why I am saying it is magnet? I will say after ending of this experiment, I will say why I call it like a magnet. Actually, it is a iron powder. It is a iron powder or iron pieces. This is the conductor connects with the battery. This is the conductor connects with battery. So this is the materials required to moisture experiment. See the procedure. Then the wire is held above the needle. Wire is held above the needle and the current flows from south to north. Current flows from south to north. The north pole of the magnetic needle gets deflected towards the west. And when the wire is placed below the needle, the direction of deflection of the needle is reversed. Actually, this is the iron pieces. When these iron pieces are brought near to the current carrying wire, these iron pieces are deflects are arranged in a in particular or parallel direction or parallel shape. So that is one of the observation I should explain. In the place of iron pieces, we have to take compass needle. We have to take compass needle. So what happened in that compass needle? When the wire is held above the needle, wire is held above the needle of the compass, current flows from south to north. The north pole of the magnetic needle gets deflected. Otherwise, when the wire is placed below the needle, the direction of the deflection needle is reverse. Okay. Next, the alignment of needle is tangential to a circle center on the wire. Circle center on the wire. See here, this is the center of the wire. The deflection is stronger on the increasing the current or bringing the needle closer to the wire. When the deflection is stronger, that means increasing the current value or needle is close to the wire. Iron fillings sprinkled around the wire arrange themselves in circles concentric to the wire. In starting onwards, I said that this is the magnets. So why I said this is the magnet? This is the iron pieces or iron filings. When these iron filings are brought near to the current carrying wire, after some time, these iron filings are arranged in the form of a circle. At that moment, these iron filings gets the magnetic properties. So that's why I call this is the magnets. Okay. So this is the Oyster experiment. What is the meaning of this Oyster experiment? When the iron material or any metals are brought near to the wire, current carrying wire, after some time it gets magnetic properties. So that is the Oyster experiment. Coming to Fleming's right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule. The direction of induced current is given by Fleming's right hand rule. See this. It states that if the thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the right hand is held perpendicular to each other such that thumb points in the direction of motion. Fold your finger like this. This is the direction of the motion. Direction of the motion indicates thumb. Next. Forefinger points in the direction of magnetic field. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. Then the middle finger shows the direction of induced current. So this is the induced current. Fleming's right hand rule or Fleming's left hand rule. These two rules indicating like this. Okay. By using the left hand, thumb indicates motion of the force. fourth finger of the left hand indicates magnetic field, and the middle finger indicates individual thumb. So this is the information in this video. That is, magnetic field around spike current carrying conductor and a circular loop. Next is magnetic effects of current, that means Oersted experiment, Fleming's right hand rule. We have two or more topics in this magnetic effects of current. In the next video, I will discuss that topics. So thanks for watching this video. For more videos, visit www.expertiseacademy.com.